everybody, welcome and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Alicia. If you've been here before, welcome back, girl or guy. Okay, so today is Vlogmas day 13. Happy Vlogmas. It is late, so I'm trying to record this as quick as possible so that I can get it edited and uploaded tonight. So today will be a 2-in-1. I have my Bath and Body Works order from the candle sale. I did not do damage this year. I only got 6 candles. I gifted one, and some of them are Old Faithfuls, and I think I got like 2 new scents. So I'll show you guys that. Matter of fact, let me do it now while I'm talking about it. So the first scent that I have is the Winterberry Wreath. Y'all don't know how I feel about this. Like, it smells good, and then it has like an after, like, I don't know what the is, and I've been trying to figure it out. Like, I had to light it last night. I don't know. It doesn't smell bad lit, but it's an interesting scent. The key notes are fresh picked orange, juicy blackberry, warm vetiver. I don't know. With natural essential oils. Like I said, I'll give it like a 6. I don't want to take it back because I want to do Christmas scents and winter scents during the winter. But it smells okay. I wouldn't just necessarily recommend it though. I ain't gonna lie. Okay, next up is Old Faithful. I get her every year because I like her. And this year she's in such a pretty package. My favorite color, pink with the snowflakes. And her name, Champagne Toast. I mean, I have one from last year that I was burning, that just finished burning, that I need to take the wax and make it into like wax melts. But the key notes are bubbly champagne, sparkling berries, and sweet orange. 10 out of 10, highly recommend. I know the candle sale is gone, but some people shop Bath and Body Works without sales, without coupons. So if you do, that's the scent. Another Old Faithful. I didn't see it in the Christmas packaging, but by the time I burn it, it probably won't be winter. Another 10 out of 10. Another fan fave, Midnight Blue Citrus. He smells pretty nice. His key notes are juicy tangerine, airy beach grass, sweet orange blossom, amber with natural essential oils. This is another one that I will always get whenever there's a sale. You know, maybe I didn't. You coming here with me? Okay. I don't think I got it. I normally get Endless Weekend, but I think when I checked out, maybe it had sold out. This is a new one. Strawberry Sparkle Give Cheer. It smells okay. This is a new one. You want to smell it? Come smell it. It smells good. Hey. Tell them, hey, say happy Vlogmas.
Hey, Vlogmas.
Happy Vlogmas. But this one smells really nice. I'll have to see what it smells like lit. I'll give it about an 8 out of 10. And I have one more. Like I said, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I picked up 5, but I gifted the mahogany teak wood to someone. Did I not open one? Hold on. What's this? Hold on, y'all. Okay, I'm back. Yeah, apparently I didn't get Endless Weekend. But I got Island Margarita. This is like a summer fruity scent. Did I do the keynotes? Yeah, I did. Okay, so the key notes is sweet mandarin, island mango, sea salt with natural essential oils. Okay, thank you. They'll break. But yeah, this one is another one that's really good. So now that we have that out of the way, today's video,
Nice, Mona. Why are you liking video?
Why I'm recording videos for YouTube.
Oh, you did that. What a big thing.
What big thing?
Yeah. On YouTube.
You want to watch me on YouTube?
Yeah.
Okay, well, hold on. Let me finish recording, okay?
Right.
Okay. Okay, so today's video will be Holiday Gift Guide Bay Edition, okay? So I have a few notes here that I'm gonna go by, but the main thing when buying your bay, this is his edition, okay? Guy edition. The main thing when buying a gift for your bay is knowing what he's into, knowing what he's like. If he's outdoorsy, is he techie? Is he into clothes, shoes, fashion, those things. You have to really know your person. Are they into materialistic things? Are they into sentimental things? Do they just don't really care about getting gifts and they just want you to be okay? Get at him. So you just have to know what you're doing. But I'll give you a basic guide of some things that I could think of. Let's start off with the basics. A watch. Like, every man needs a good watch. The old folks that say, don't buy a man a watch, you'll watch him walk out to life or some mess like that. But if you don't believe in those superstitions, you can get him a really nice watch. There are various brands. I mean, if he's into Apple, Samsung, like fitness watches, or Elijah, cut it down. Basic watches, like I say, if he's into Apple fitness, Fitbit, you can do those watches. You could do Fossil, Michael Kors, whatever he's into. If he's into that type of thing, you can get a really nice watch for a budget. A lot of places are doing Christmas sales, so get online, Google Mail watches, and I'm pretty sure some stuff will pop up. Wallet. Amazon has really nice wallets. They have kinds that are inscripted. I gifted my boyfriend one last year. If he's a simple guy, Walmart has basic watches. Coach has a really nice brand in this year. You can go to Coach, get him a Coach wallet. Michael Kors, whatever he's into, you can get him something high-end, low-end, wallets, watches, those things. You can range with those. Cologne. I feel like every man should smell wonderful, okay? a couple of references that I have, the Tiffany and Love for him. It's the matching for her. So maybe you and Bae can get matching scents. Same thing with the Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue. They have a female and a male version. The next one, people pronounce it different. Sauvage or Savage, whichever one by Dior. That's a really nice scent. If you don't have that span on such name brand, you can go to the beauty supply store. I mean, depending on your budget, you can get the roller balls for men, or you can get Curve, or go to Walmart and they'll have like the smaller versions of the high-end colognes for a lower price. Like I said, Old Faithful, clothes and shoes. Same thing with the shoes. Some old people advise you not to do it. Say they'll walk out your life. What was the thing with the watch? Watch wasn't watch and walk out of your life. Watch was your time. Something about time will be limited. And then shoes, you'll watch them walk out your life. But that's only if you believe in the old folks' superstitions, okay? If you don't, get your man a watch. Get your man some shoes. Get him a nice clothes. Get him some nice clothes. Buy your man something that you want to see in men, right? So if he's into just chill, laying back, and when y'all go on date nights, y'all always fighting about what he's putting on, get him something for him to wear to date night. If he's into the turtlenecks, the coats, like whatever, anything fashion, if he's into it. Same thing with jewelry. If you got a guy that's into jewelry, necklaces, bracelets, earrings, if his ears are pierced. I mean, me and jewelry. Okay, now let's get a little more specific. So if your guy is outdoorsy, maybe hunting gear. I don't want to say the word. I don't know if YouTube is all about it, but you know what you use to go hunt with to get your prey? Yeah. Get him one of those. Pay for his fishing license or his hunting permit or whatever. Like, whatever. Because I'm not really into that stuff. But pay for him a subscription somewhere. Get him some really nice boots, like fishing boots or hunting boots. The coveralls, those are really nice. The bibs, all that stuff. If you got an outdoorsy guy, come sit in my lap. Because you're doing too much. A shed. If he's into, you want them to see you playing your game? Okay. Sorry, y'all, if y'all can hear his game. He won't. We've been fighting about him cutting it down. Okay, you play it. You play it. A nice he shed, or just a shed to keep his tools in. Yard tools, lawnmowers, garden hose, shovels, rakes. You know, did I say lawnmower? Yeah. Just different stuff if he's into the outdoor stuff. If he's a gamer, you can get him a gaming chair, headsets, the wireless headsets, controllers for his game, blue light glasses, because if he's in front of the TV all day, he's going to need some protection for his eyes. What else do I have on here? If he has a game system that still takes the disc, you can get him disc. If he's digital, then get him a gift card for his, for whatever, Xbox, PlayStation, Nintendo, whatever he's into. If he's a tech guy, depends on your budget. Because tech is expensive. Maybe a projector, the projector screen. So that's something that could benefit you both, indoor date night. What else is techie? Like I said, it depends on your budget. If you can afford it, an iPad or some other form of a tablet or earbuds, the Beats, whatever. Y'all, I'm babysitting and I got work to do. He just won't sit down. So, anywho, a lot of things take into account when it comes to gifting. Make sure you talk to your partner and see if gifts are something that you want to do. If so, maybe y'all want to set a budget. You know, if you only been together 3 months and you coming up on Christmas, you don't want to blow $200-$400 on this man, and you don't know if he'll be around for next Christmas, okay? Not to jinx your relationship, but just saying, you just don't know. Or if y'all been together forever and y'all gifted each other everything under the sun, maybe something homemade, you know, like what? If y'all been together a while, maybe something sentimental like a scrapbook of a timeline of y'all's relationship or. Elijah, you loud. A timeline of y'all's relationship or something about y'all. Just something dedicated to y'all's relationship. Something about his family. If he has a parent that's deceased, maybe something that's a memorial to one of his, you know, to his parents or sibling or something. If y'all have children together, let your kids get them a real sentimental gift. Put their little handprints on some. Elijah. Shh. let the kids do something sweet for them. And just remember, guys, that everybody's financial situation is different. Don't let your girlfriends, co-workers, you know, my man got me a $500 bracelet, or, you know, I'm buying my man this $5,000 ATV or whatever. It's not about how much you spend. It's about the thought that you put into the gift. Make sure that it's from your heart. Make sure that it's something you feel that they would like, and something that they'd appreciate. I think to me, that's all that matters. If you put effort and thought into it, if he's the right kind of man, he'll appreciate it. Or easy alternative. Babe, what do you want for Christmas? Just ask him straight up, what do you want for Christmas? And let him tell you what he wants. But that's it for today's video. I'm going to keep it sweet. This one is loud. He keeps getting louder and louder. He wants to talk and play and all that other stuff. And my shirt for the day says working on my Santa bot. There's a gingerbread, hot cocoa, candy cane, and then the sleeves are a depiction of the front. Comment down below, let me know if anything that I mentioned will be something that you're interested in getting your bae, or if you've already got bae's gift and it's wrapped up, let me know what you got them, girl, so we can help the sisters out, you know. It's a couple of days before Christmas. We got about, less than a week? No, a little over a week, like a week and a half until Christmas. So, y'all be safe out there, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye. Bye.